I'm Sara, and today we're going to perform nasooropharyngeal suctioning. So I'm going to check my patient's chart for an order. We have here Morgan Brown, MR number 589-131325, date of birth 8-4-70. He has no known allergies. He has an order here for nasopharyngeal suctioning, PRN. I also want to check to see if he has a history of nasal trauma, polyps, deviated septum, and if there's any pain medication, if postoperative, that I could give prior to the procedure. I'm now going to gather my equipment. We need a Yankar, pen light, pulse ox, sterile saline, suction kit, and our blue drape. Now I'm about to go to the patient's room. Hi Morgan, it's Sara, your nurse. I'm here to do some suctioning. It looks like your breathing's a little more labored and that you have some congestion in your chest. Can you tell me your name and date of birth?
Sure, Morgan Brown, 8-4-70.
Great, all right. Are you having any pain?
No.
Okay, I'm just gonna put a little catheter down your nose and try and get some of that phlegm and secretions out of your chest to make your breathing easier and to make you feel better.
Okay.
Does your breathing feel hard right now?
All
right, I'm going to sit you up a little higher there. I'm going to get all set up. Do you have any history of facial surgeries or head trauma to your face?
No.
Okay, great. I'm going to turn the suction on here. For an adult, it's 100 to 150. For a child, 100 to 120. I'm going to put this little device on your finger to check your oxygen levels. Oh, it looks like you're about 87-88%. That's low. Hopefully this suctioning should make that better and make you feel better. I'm going to put this little blue drape over your chest. If any time you're uncomfortable, let me know, okay? I see you're on some oxygen. I'm gonna increase it about 1 to 2 liters. If you could just take some nice deep breaths through your nose. I'm gonna get all set up here. Thing is really sticky. Okay, I'm gonna set up, this is my little saline device. I'm gonna put that here. You wanna set that up before you put on your sterile gloves. I'm gonna pour some sterile saline into the box. Now remember, when you're suctioning, you always want to have a clean hand and a sterile hand, and you should be suctioning with your dominant hand. Okay, you want to be careful with the catheter not to wave it around. I'm going to connect it here to my suction tubing. keeping this hand clean. This hand will be sterile. I'm going to control my suction with, right here with my thumb. Remember, when you're going down, you don't want to apply suction. You only want to apply suction on the way back up. Okay, I'm going to prime with my saline. Okay, Morgan. I'm going to remove the oxygen here. So I'm going to go down on the left nair. It might be a little uncomfortable. Okay, here we go. Okay, I'm going to reapply the oxygen. I'm going to clear my suction catheter. Okay, Morgan, we're going to go down one more time there. Looks like you had some nice secretions there. They're thick and white. Here we go. All right. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to actually suction you through your mouth to see if there's anything else in the back of your throat that we can get out of there. Okay, go down through the side of the mouth, back of the throat. Okay, and okay, how does that feel, Morgan? Morgan, you okay? Okay.
Yeah, it seems a little better.
All right, and then let's see if you got a little something in your mouth here that I can clear out. Use a yank hour. All right. Now, I'm going to go ahead. Oh, it looks like your oxygen level went up to about 93%. That's an improvement. That's good. We're done with the suctioning. I'm going to listen to your lungs, see how everything sounds. Take a deep breath. Another deep breath. Again. 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 Okay. Sounds better. I'm going to put all my stuff back. Is there anything else I can get for you right now, Morgan?
No, I feel better.
Great. Just put your bed down. I'm going to take my little device back. I see you have your call light. I'll be back in about an hour to check on you, but please feel free to push your call light if you need anything sooner. Let me fix your oxygen here, and then I'm going to turn down your, put that back to what you were previously at. Now I'm back at the nurse's station and I'm going to document the procedure that I just did. I want to document the respiratory rate, lung sounds, how the patient tolerated the procedure, the color and consistency of the secretions. I will then go back to the room within an hour to check on the patient as I stated. This now completes our skill of nasal oral pharyngeal suctioning.